In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how we can use custom formula filters in pivot tables and basically have them act as a slicer, which could have advantages to it compared to a basic slicer that's already available in Sheets. Now, first of all, let's try to build a pivot table from this. So I'm going to go ahead and select all of these columns. Notice that I'm selecting the whole column. And the reason for this is because I don't want to update this pivot table. I just want it to update automatically as we add more data to this. So I'm going to go to insert and do pivot table and basically just hit create. That's going to build the pivot table. And for now, I'll just go ahead and pick some sort of value. Sales would be good. And under rows, I'll select, you know, one of the columns. It doesn't matter. So right now we get our total per rep. This, see, we got some blanks. And that's because, well, like this one doesn't have anything assigned to it. Now, if you do assign something to it, so let's say we do this. If I go back, it will now shift here and our total for blanks will be zero. Now, the reason we still get this blanks is because we selected the whole thing to also include all these empty rows. But right now we're gonna ignore that. We're gonna continue with the rest of this. So let's say I want to filter this by region. So one way I could do that, I could go here and under filters, I could add region. And then we would have this filter over here that we could just go here and select one of these regions. And that would give us the total for that region. Let's just go back to everything in this. So at this point, let's actually move on to using formulas to do our filtering. So if I go ahead and go to filter by condition, here we have an option, custom formula is, and that allows you to write a formula here. And our formula would start with equal sign. Then we want to use one of the columns in our data set. So for example, the column that I had was called region. So I'm going to go ahead and type that column as is. If the column has spaces, you would basically put single quotes around this like so. I don't have spaces in this column name, so I'm just going to do this. And we can just check if that equals to a value. So for now, let's just say I'm checking if that's Midwest, like so. And Midwest text goes in quotes like this. And you could do any logical comparison here. You could do greater than, less than, not equal to, whatever you gotta do. So at this point, if I hit okay, we should see how this filters. And we're right now looking at just basically Midwest totals. Now, what's nice about this, we can link that formula to a cell. So what I could do, I could go to a cell like this and type Midwest. And then I could go back to this and go to this filter. And instead of having this, I could just erase that and point to that E1 cell, which holds that value Midwest. So if I press OK, that would still filter to Midwest. Now, if I go and change this Midwest to, let's say, West, everything will change because we're now filtering to everything that matches West in this column, again, based on the value we got in here. So now I could create some sort of dropdown of different values and basically have this more interactive experience. So let's just go ahead and build something like that. So I'm going to create a new sheet. I'm just going to call it Dropdown. And for now, I'll just create a unique list of items from this regions column. So I'll just simply go here and do equals unique. And as a range, I'm going to go to my data, select about this much, drop the end reference, starting from B2 all the way down, close parentheses, hit enter, and you should see how we got a nice unique list. Now I could also sort this list alphabetically by adding sort function, around this, like so. So now I have this sorted. And at this point, I could just go to this, click to data, data validation, list from a range, go to this box, go to that dropdown and select this whole column A, press OK, and reject any other input, press save. And at this point, if I go back to here, you'll see we have a dropdown of different possible options. And if I check one, it will basically just filter our pivot table accordingly to basically give us the total for that particular region. Now you might want to also add some sort of all option. And for that, I'll go to that dropdown and add another row on top of this. And I'll just type as that option all, or you can call it all regions or whatever you want to call it. You want to make sure whatever you choose here as all is not going to be one of the available options you might have in your data. So once I got this here, now we should have that all here. But at this point, if I select all, nothing is going to get selected because, well, we don't have any region called all. So what we're going to do, we're going to go back and update this formula here. And what we'll do, we'll say if that E1 equals all, or whatever you decided to name that, comma. In this case, I basically want to just display all values, right? So what I'll do, I'll just type true, comma. In all the other cases, I'm just gonna check if region equals E1, like so. So with this, I'm gonna press okay. And as you can see, it's still Midwest, like it should be. And if I switch back to all, we'll get all the options. If I go to Midwest, we're gonna get Midwest. This, we're gonna get this. West, we're gonna get that. All, we'll get this. Now, let me explain you why I prefer this to built-in slicers that are available here. So if I click Add Slicer on this pivot table, at least as of today, the way this works, if I choose that same region column to filter, right? Which is gonna be this. I cannot select dynamic range here. See how it goes from A1 through E20, which is here. So if I want to, let's just click on this and add its slicer. So if I want to make this range dynamic, I cannot drop that 20 like so. If I hit enter, see it hard codes the last row in a spreadsheet there. If I try to do the whole column like this, it still hard codes the reference there. For this one, it wouldn't matter because my formula here links to the whole column all the way down. So it's still gonna update dynamically as I go forward. So I'm gonna get rid of this. So let's just do a quick demo of adding a different region. So I'll go back here and assign one of these to a region. Let's just call it Southeast or something. And let's also add another record. I'll just make this easy, copy paste, and just change it to Southeast as well. So we should now have two Southeast. One of them is this much and the other one, let's just assign some amount. And if I go back to my pivot table, go to this, and you'll see it automatically shows up here. If I click on this, it will just filter to those results like you would expect. You can go here and label this. You can move this. As you're moving this, be careful. You probably want to move it before you build this formulas. But in our case, you know, right now, if I try to, say, add a few rows above this and then maybe move this on top here, like so. Let's see if it updates it automatically or not. Interestingly enough, it seems like it did. So it did link to the right cell. That's nice. So we'll just call this region. And we can just color code this as we wish. And we have our nice dynamic slicer going on here. I could even connect the same cell to multiple pivot tables as a filter. And that would work out, something I couldn't do with a regular slicer unless it's using the same range of data. So now I have a lot more flexibility, and then also I think it's just easier for users like this than the actual design we get with the regular slicer. And again, you could really just use any formula that outputs true and false. Now you have a bunch of options like all the regular expression functions and everything else. If you want to learn more about logical tests and all of these other functions, I have a lot of videos covering that, but this should just give you a preview how custom formulas work in filters. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.